स्टूडेंट्स कैन यू हियर मी?
यस मैम।
ओके कैन यू सी द स्क्रीन?
यस मैम।
So today we'll be discussing about sex determination as well as sex linkage. So we all know that male and female reproductive organs, if they are present on the same plant, these are known as bisexual or hermaphrodite. And if different flowers are present on the same plant, what they are known?
Monoecious.
Okay. And male and female are produced on different plants. These are known as dioecious. And the famous example is papaya as well as asparagus. Okay, write down the examples that are I am just telling in these in this chapter or slides as slides pass on. Just write down the examples. They are very important. So papaya and asparagus, they are dioecious plants. And these three families, that is Cucurbitaceae, Cannabidaceae, as well as Salicaceae, they have unisexual flowers. Their plants have unisexual flowers. Okay. And the monoecious plants also produce other type of flower combinations. They can be andromonaceous, gynomonaceous, and trimonaceous. What is andromonaceous?
Along with monoecious, they also produce male.
What? It's not clear, actually. I cannot hear you.
Along with the monoecious nature, they also produce androecious part.
Yes, male as well as hermaphrodite plants will be present in the same plant. Gynomonaceous is?
Gynoecium along with the monoecious.
Yeah, okay. And what is trimonaceous?
Androecium plus gynoecium plus monoecy.
Yeah. So trimonaceous is all the three flower types will present on the same plant. Okay, so this is the basic mechanism of sex determination. Okay, this is the mechanism of sex determination in plants. Actually, we are dealing with plants actually. So I have taken the example of plants also in the sex linkage chapter. So mechanism of sex determination, it can be of three types in plants mainly. It is of environmental type in case of equisetum species. Okay, chromosomal, that is one type is homomorphic chromosomes and another type is heteromorphic chromosomes. So actually, basically, you must have learned till now that that XY chromosome is heteromorphic in nature and homomorphic it is XX. So here it is like homomorphic chromosomes, it is coming heterogametic male as well as heterogametic. So heterogametes are also coming in homomorphic chromosomes here. The thing is that they will be having certain regions, they will be very similar to each other. They will be having certain regions on X chromosome that will be similar in Y chromosomes as well. And that's why they are known as homomorphic chromosome, even though they are two different chromosomes. Okay. So the homomorphic chromosome, it covers heterogametic male as well as heterogametic female. And the second is heteromorphic chromosome, that is they will be having XX and XY also. And in this, they will be having certain difference between X and Y chromosome. That's why they are categorized under heteromorphic chromosomes. Even though here also XY comes, here also XY comes. But here the XY will be having similar functions. Similar functions or similar genes will be there in both of them. So, if X is Y alone is present in an individual, it will survive. Okay, so that is the case for homomorphic chromosomes. In heteromorphic chromosomes also, XX, XY, and there are certain new gene combinations produced. That is XX, that is for the female. XY1, Y2, that is for male. Then X1, X2, X1, X2, X1, X2, Y1, Y2. So this is found in The normal thing is found is silene latifolia. This type of chromosome combination, that is XX, XY1, Y2, is found in Rumex acetosa. And X1, X2, this type of complex chromosome constitution is found in humerus lupulus. Okay. So more, you know, commonly it is asked about asparagus and spinach and also Fragaria elitaria. You need to learn these two things only. And just write down, if you want to write these things also, you can write it down. Just I will explain it, actually. That is the only case. And the third is genic. Genic means one single locus will be, that is the autosomal genes. Autosomal genes will be involved in controlling the sex of the individual. So it can be single locus. Single locus can be seen in Ekbalium elitarium, and multiple loci will be involved along with the sex chromosome to determine the sex of the individual. So it will be Mercurialis annua. Any problem till now?
No, ma'am.
You can understand, no, these things. It's a little new for you. That's why I'm asking. If it is any problem.
Ma'am, please go homomorphic and heteromorphic.
होमोमॉर्फिक के अंदर क्या होता है कि मतलब ये जो एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम है, एक्स एक्स तो आप छोड़ो, एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम के अंदर क्या होता है मेनली, एक्चुअली अपन को एक्स के अंदर बहुत सारे ऐसे जीन्स होते हैं जो डिस्पाइट ऑफ सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन बहुत वाइटल होते हैं अपने जीने के लिए. मतलब बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें होती है एक्स क्रोमोसोम के अंदर जो मतलब बहुत वाइटल होती हैं. वो कुछ ऐसी प्रोटीन्स वो प्रोड्यूस करती है जो बहुत वाइटल होती हैं. बट क्या होता है कि होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम के अंदर ये जो एक्स और वाई क्रोमोसोम होता है वो दोनों सिमिलर होते हैं. एक्चुअली सिमिलर मतलब बहुत ज्यादा सिमिलैरिटी होती है एक्सेप्ट फॉर मेल एंड फीमेल डिटरमिनिंग फैक्टर. बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें होती है बहुत सिमिलर होती हैं. तो इसलिए अपन इसको कैटेगराइज करते हैं होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम के अंदर. बिकॉज क्योंकि अगर वाई भी अगर अकेला प्रेजेंट हो एक इंडिविजुअल के अंदर, एक्स प्रेजेंट ना हो, अपन आगे देखेंगे एस्परागस का एक केस होता है जिसके अंदर एस्परागस के अंदर मेल्स जो होते हैं सुपर मेल्स करके बोलते हैं उसको, उसको कैपिटल वाई होते हैं वो लोग, उसके अंदर एक्स होता ही नहीं है. साधारण क्या होता है कि मतलब मेल्स के अंदर एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम्स होता है बट इसके अंदर सुपर वाई सुपर मेल्स बोलते हैं इसको. तो ये वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम्स होता है इसके अंदर बट ये लोग जीते हैं और ये फर्टाइल भी होते हैं क्योंकि इनके अंदर दो वाई क्रोमोसोम्स भी हैं फिर भी वो जी रहे और फर्टाइल हैं. तो मतलब इसका मतलब एक्स की जरूरत नहीं है इनको. तो इसका मतलब एक्स के कोई जीन्स ऐसे थोड़ी जीन्स हैं जो मतलब वाई के अंदर इनके वाई के अंदर प्रेजेंट होती हैं. तो ये ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर होती हैं एक्सेप्ट फॉर यू नो सेक्स डिटर्मिनेशन. सेक्स तो मतलब वाई जो क्रोमोसोम है वो तो सेक्स ही डिटरमाइन करेगा कि मतलब वाई क्रोमोसोम अगर हो तो मेल ही होगा और अगर एक्स है तो फीमेल ही होगा. सो दैट इज द केस फॉर होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम दैट इज सीन इन केस ऑफ प्लांट्स. ओके. एंड हेटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम के अंदर एज यूजुअल जो अपना नॉर्मल चीज होती है कि एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम मतलब बहुत ही अलग होता है स्ट्रक्चर में और एक्स चाहिए ही चाहिए उनको. दैट इज द केस फॉर हेटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम. अंडरस्टूड टिल नाउ?
यस मैम.
ओके
मैम, ये जो XX, XY है तो सपोज फर्स्ट सेकंड वन का ये जो लिखा हुआ है हेटेरोक्रोमैटिक मेल XX, XY, तो ये दोनों मेल ही फंक्शन करेंगे as like if they are present as XX or XY, whatever the dose of Y or X.
किसके अंदर? किसके अंदर?
वन का ये जो लिखा हुआ है हेटेरोक्रोमैटिक मेल,
उसके अंदर फीमेल XX ही होगी, XY मेल ही होगा. बट ऐसे केसेस होते हैं जिसके अंदर YY भी पाए जाते हैं. बट वो YY अगर साधारण अपन जैसे अपन देखें कि मतलब साधारण जैसे ह्यूमन बींग्स में या ड्रोसोफिला में देखें, ये YY क्रोमोसोम वाले जो लोग होते हैं ना वो कभी जिंदा नहीं रहते या मतलब वो फर्टाइल ही नहीं होते. बट उसके अंदर क्या है कि मतलब फर्टाइल है वो. मतलब इसका एग्जाम्पल आएगा एस्पेरागस के अंदर, वो कैसे फर्टाइल है, एक्स क्रोमोसोम तो है नहीं उनके अंदर. तो मतलब इसका मतलब वाई के अंदर ऐसे जीन्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं एक्स के जो उनको मतलब फर्टिलिटी और जो इनको मतलब वाइटैलिटी प्रोवाइड करते हैं मतलब. तो इसलिए अपन इनको होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम्स कहते हैं. समझ आया?
इससे भी तो हम फीमेल मेल सिस्टम बोल ही सकते हैं.
क्या क्या क्या?
फीमेल मेल सिस्टम जो होता है जनरल एलोजॉमिक सिस्टम.
हाँ कह सकते हैं, कह सकते हैं. बट इसलिए मैं बोल रही हूँ कि अपने होमोमॉर्फिक और हेटेरोमॉर्फिक में इनको क्यों मतलब इनको डिवाइड किए हैं क्योंकि ये लोग सिमिलर हैं, एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम इनके अंदर सिमिलर होते हैं. बट हेटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम अपन क्यों बोलते हैं कि मतलब एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम जो होता है वो सिमिलर नहीं होते, वो दोनों की जरूरत पड़ती है मेल्स के अंदर. समझ आया?
अच्छा, उनका इफेक्ट सेम ही रहता है.
किसका?
सपोज फर्टिलिटी माना हमने तो इफेक्ट रहता है. ये नहीं कह सकते कि वाई है तभी करेगा, ना रहे तो स्टेरिलिटी हो जाए, ऐसा कुछ नहीं
साधारण
होता
अपन
है।
अभी जैसे देखो ड्रोसोफिला में देख लो या जैसे ह्यूमंस में देख लो, वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम कभी आपने सुना है?
नहीं मैम, सुपर
कभी नहीं
मेल
सुना
का एक
होगा। नहीं, अगर सुना भी होगा ना तो वो लोग डाई करते हैं अर्ली एज के ना, जरूर मतलब एक्स जरूरी है बिकॉज एक्स बहुत ज्यादा मतलब वाइटैलिटी प्रोवाइड करता है, वो चीज बहुत सारी जीन्स होती है उसके अंदर जो मतलब सेक्स के अलावा भी बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें होती है उसके अंदर जो वाइटैलिटी प्रोवाइड करती है कि इंडिविजुअल को, इसलिए एक्स एक इंडिविजुअल के अंदर होना जरूरी है। एक्चुअली फीमेल्स की बात छोड़ो, मेल्स के अंदर आते हैं, ठीक है, मेल्स के अंदर इसके अंदर एक्स वाई क्रोमोजोम है, बट इसके अंदर क्या है, केसेस देखे गए हैं जिसके अंदर वाई वाई क्रोमोजोम भी पाए गए हैं, बट वो वाई वाई क्रोमोजोम अगर साधारण नॉर्मल या मतलब ह्यूमन से या ड्रोसोफिला या किसी भी प्लांट के अंदर आ जाए ना, तो मतलब वो लोग जिंदा नहीं रहते क्योंकि एक वाई क्रोमोजोम से कुछ नहीं होता, बट इसके अंदर क्या है, दो वाई क्रोमोजोम से फिर भी वो जिंदा है मतलब, तो इसका मतलब ये एक्स क्रोमोजोम के अंदर जो जीन्स हैं वो मतलब इस वाई क्रोमोजोम के अंदर भी होंगी, तभी वो उसे वाइटैलिटी और फर्टिलिटी भी प्रोवाइड कर रही है मतलब, समझ आया?
यस मैम।
तो इसलिए अपन इसे बोलेंगे होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोजोम बिकॉज दोनों सिमिलर हैं, मैं आइडेंटिकल नहीं कह रही, सिमिलर हैं, बहुत ज्यादा सिमिलर मतलब ज्यादा वो लेंथ भी ब्रेथ भी सेम होगा या मतलब ऐसे नहीं, मतलब जीन्स बहुत ज्यादा सेम होती है उसके अंदर, इसलिए अपन इसको होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोजोम्स कहते हैं। हिटेरोमॉर्फिक के अंदर अपन बहुत ज्यादा डिफरेंस देख सकते हैं क्योंकि उसके अंदर कोई जीन्स भी प्रेजेंट नहीं होगी और साथ में शेप में साइज में भी डिफरेंस होगा, इसलिए अपन इसको हिटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोजोम्स कहते हैं। समझ आया?
यस मैम।
समझ आया तो मैं आगे बढ़ूंगी, थोड़ा सा न्यू कंसेप्ट है इसलिए मैं बोल रही हूँ।
यस मैम।
ओके, सो फर्स्ट विल बी द एनवायरमेंटल सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन। एनवायरमेंट से जो सेक्स डिटरमाइन होता है, सो इट इज जनरली अफेक्टेड बाय एनवायरमेंट। इक्विसिटम प्लांट्स को एग्जांपल में ले लो, ऑप्टिमम कंडीशंस में फीमेल प्रोड्यूस होती है, बट अगर एडवर्स कंडीशंस हो तो मेल प्रोड्यूस होता है एक्चुअली इक्विसिटम प्लांट्स के अंदर, ठीक है। फिर द सेकेंड इज द मेलन्स क्यूक्यूम्बर एंड कैनबिस। सो सेक्स ऑफ द फ्लावर्स इज अफेक्टेड बाई टेम्परेचर, डे लेंथ, इथाइलिन एंड जिबोलिक एसिड प्रोडक्शन एंड आयन सच एस Mg+2 एंड Ca+2। तो इनको अगर अपन एक्सोजीनसली मतलब बाहर से अपन ये हॉर्मोन्स और ये सब प्रोवाइड करते हैं तो उसका सेक्स चेंज हो सकता है एक्चुअली। दैट इज द केस फॉर मेलन्स, क्यूक्यूम्बर एंड कैनबिस। ओके, एंड एनवायरमेंट हैज मोर प्रोनाउंस इफेक्ट ऑन मेल्स देन ऑन फीमेल्स। Now, second करेंगे अपन क्रोमोसोमल सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन। सो द क्रोमोसोमल इन्फ्लुएंस ऑन सेक्स इन सर्टेन इंसेक्ट्स, दैट इज मैकक्लंग 1902 टू बी एसोसिएटेड विद अ स्पेशल सेक्स डिटरमाइनिंग क्रोमोसोम। सबसे पहले मैकक्लंग ने बोला था कि मतलब सेक्स जो है वो एक स्पेशल डिटरमिनिंग एक्स क्रोमोसोम से रिलेटेड होता है एक्चुअली। सो ही प्रपोज दैट अ मेल हैड वन एक्स क्रोमोसोम पर सेल, दैट इज मेल विल बी हैविंग एक्स एंड फीमेल विल बी हैविंग टू एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स पर सेल। तो द स्टीवंस एंड विल्सन ने ये जब अपना एक्सपेरिमेंट किया मिल्क वीट बग के अंदर, तब उन्होंने भी सेम ही रिजल्ट पाया। सो मैकक्लंग याद रखना है, स्टीवंस एंड विल्सन याद रखना है, ठीक है। इन फीमेल्स ऑल द क्रोमोसोम्स वर पेयर्ड एंड द होमोलोग्स वर इक्वल इन साइज, सो इसलिए अपन बोलते हैं उसको होमोमॉर्फिक। ये मैं एनिमल्स के केस की बात कर रही हूँ, प्लांट्स की बात थी जो मैंने ये आगे कही थी एक्चुअली। प्लांट्स के अंदर ऐसा होता है, एनिमल्स के अंदर नॉर्मली होमोमॉर्फिक मतलब एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स एक्स एक्स जब दो एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स होंगे तब होमोमॉर्फिक होता है। इन द मेल ऑल द क्रोमोसोम्स वर पेयर्ड बट द क्रोमोसोम्स आइडेंटिफाइड एज होमोलॉगस टू एक्स क्रोमोसोम दैट वाज डिस्टिंक्टली स्मॉलर, दैट इज वाई क्रोमोसोम। तो उसके बेसिस में वो स्मॉल है एक्स से, तो इसलिए उसको हेटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम्स कहते हैं। समझ आया अभी तक?
यस मैम।
प्लांट्स और एनिमल्स का डिफरेंशिएशन होता है डिफरेंट एक्चुअली, बिकॉज प्लांट्स के अंदर अलग से होमोमॉर्फिक हेटेरोमॉर्फिक हैं, एनिमल्स के अंदर बेस्ड ऑन साइज एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स अपन इसको डिफरेंशिएट करते हैं। सो टू टाइप्स होते हैं क्रोमोसोम सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन के, दैट इज हेटेरोगैमेटिक मेल। सो फीमेल सेक्स हैज टू एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स, मेल हैज ओनली सिंगल सेक्स क्रोमोसोम एक्स क्रोमोसोम। सो द मेल एज मेल लैक्स एक्स क्रोमोसोम ड्यूरिंग मियोसिस, 50% of the gametes will carry X chromosome and while the rest do not have the X chromosome, या तो नहीं होते या Y chromosome होते हैं। तो दो cases होते हैं इसके अंदर, that is X X not chromosome और XX XY chromosome। So ये कहाँ पे देखा गया, जिसके अंदर X और X not chromosome जिसके अंदर होता है Hemiptera, that is true bugs, ऑर्थोप्टेरा ग्रासहॉपर्स एंड डिक्टियोप्टेरा क्रॉकरोचेस. ये याद रखना है एक्चुअली, ये इंसेक्ट्स के नाम भी याद रखने हैं, प्लांट्स के तो आपको याद रखने ही हैं, साथ में इंसेक्ट्स के भी नाम याद रखने हैं बिकॉज ये पूछे जाते हैं एक्चुअली. ठीक है, फिर एक्स वाई के अंदर तो मैन आ गया, फिर अदर मैमल, सर्टेन इंसेक्ट्स इंक्लूडिंग ड्रोसोफिला, सर्टेन एंजियोस्पर्मिक प्लांट्स इंक्लूडिंग मेलेंड्रियम. प्लांट्स का याद रखना है हमेशा, याद रखना. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद द फीमेल्स 2X क्रोमोसोम दैट इज XX दैट इज होमोगैमेटिक एंड होमोमॉर्फिक बोलते हैं उसको. होमोगैमेटिक मतलब एक ही गैमेट है उसके अंदर, सिमिलर गैमेट है, होमोमॉर्फिक है. मेल्स के अंदर 1X है और 1Y क्रोमोसोम है, दैट इज हेटेरोगैमेटिक एंड हेटेरोमॉर्फिक. आगे बढ़ो, समझ आया?
यस मैम.
ओके, अब सेकेंड केस की बात आएंगे. यहाँ पे क्या चल रहा था, हिटेरोगेमेटिक मेल की बात चल रही थी, यहाँ पे आएगी अभी हिटेरोगेमेटिक फीमेल. तो इसके अंदर होमोमॉर्फिक, ओके, मेल 2 होमोमॉर्फिक सेक्स क्रोमोसोम होते हैं उनके अंदर, दैट इज होमोगेमेटिक. इसके अंदर क्या होगा, मेल्स के अंदर होगा सेम सेक्स क्रोमोसोम, दैट विल बी होमोगेमेटिक इन नेचर. एंड फीमेल के अंदर होगा एक तो एक्स क्रोमोसोम होगा या वाई क्रोमोसोम होगा या कुछ और, उसका Y का अलग से कुछ होगा. तो एक्स वाई अपन बोलेंगे नहीं एक्चुअली फीमेल्स के अंदर. इसके अंदर एक्चुअली मैंने गलती से लिख दिया, ये एक्चुअली हेटेरोगैमेटिक सेक्स होता है फीमेल का इसके अंदर. तो इसके अंदर टू टाइप्स पाए गए, दैट इज जेड जीरो एंड जेड जेड एंड जेड डब्ल्यू एंड जेड जेड. दैट इज मॉथ्स एंड बटरफ्लाइज के अंदर ये पाया गया, जिसके अंदर फीमेल्स के अंदर होता है जेड जीरो एंड जेड जेड जो होता है मेल्स के अंदर होता है. इसके अंदर एक क्रॉस है छोटा सा, इसके अंदर फीमेल और मेल्स को जब अपन क्रॉस करेंगे तो क्या पाएंगे, क्या पाया जाता है, दैट इज जेड जेड जब आया तब मेल हो गया और जेड जीरो जब आया तब फीमेल हो गया. तो ये सेकेंड है जेड डब्ल्यू एंड जेड जेड. ये कहाँ पे पाया जाता है, ये फिशेस के अंदर, रेप्टाइल्स के अंदर और सबसे ज्यादा अपन पढ़ते हैं एक्चुअली, कॉमन थिंग इज बर्ड्स एक्चुअली एंड जिप्सी मॉथ इंसेक्ट के अंदर पाया गया. तो इन सब के एक्चुअली एग्जाम्पल्स याद रखना, बाकी कुछ याद करने की इतनी जरूरत नहीं है, बट इसके एग्जाम्पल्स याद रखने बहुत जरूरी है. इवन एनिमल्स ऑल्सो एंड प्लांट्स एक्चुअली आपके फर्दर स्टडीज के लिए बहुत काम आएंगे, तो इसलिए मैंने प्लांट्स को भी इंक्लूड किया इसके अंदर. ठीक है, तो प्लांट्स के अंदर मैंने अभी जैसे कहा पहले वो एस्पराजिस की बात कही थी, तो अपन एक बार देखेंगे इसके अंदर होमोमॉर्फिक और हेटेरोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम्स क्या होते हैं इसके अंदर. ठीक है, तो जैसे फर्स्ट बात है दैट इज एक्स एक्स फीमेल एंड एक्स वाई मेल. ये होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम की बात चल रही है, जिसके अंदर एक्स वाई मेल जो होता है, एक्स और वाई जो होता है वो सिमिलर होता है, जीन स्ट्रक्चर उनका सिमिलर होता है, जीनिक जो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन होता है उनका थोड़ा सिमिलर होता है. ठीक है, दिस इज फाउंड इन सम स्पीशीज लाइक एस्पराजिस एंड स्पिनच. ये याद रखना है, एस्पराजिस एंड स्पिनच. ओके, फीमेल्स आर होमोगैमेटिक और मेल्स क्या होते हैं, हेटेरोगैमेटिक इन नेचर. एंड सी द एक्स वाई, एक्स एंड वाई क्रोमोसोम्स आर आइडेंटिकल इन मॉर्फोलॉजी एंड सेग्रीगेट रैंडमली. आइडेंटिकल इन मॉर्फोलॉजी होते हैं इसके अंदर, इसलिए अपन इसको होमोमॉर्फिक सेक्स क्रोमोसोम के अंदर एक्स वाई को भी इंक्लूड करते हैं. ठीक है, प्लांट्स के केस के अंदर ही याद रखना, एनिमल्स के केसेस में नॉर्मली यही होता है, एक्स क्रोमोसोम जो होता है बड़ा होता है एज कम्पेयर टू वाई क्रोमोसोम्स. तो उनके अंदर ये बात आई नहीं रही है, तो उनके अंदर सिंपली हेटेरोगैमेटिक और होमोगैमेटिक हो गया. बट इसके अंदर होमोमॉर्फिक मतलब एक्स 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 वाई फीमेल भी आती है, हेटेरोमॉर्फिक के अंदर भी एक्स 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 वाई फीमेल आती है. ठीक है, फिर उसके बाद द वाई क्रोमोसोम इज थॉट टू कंटेन अ जीन दैट सप्रेसेस द कार्पल डेवलपमेंट एंड अनदर जीन दैट प्रमोट्स द स्टेमन डेवलपमेंट. तो उसी वाई क्रोमोसोम के अंदर प्रेजेंट होता है एक जीन जो क्या करता है, कार्पल डेवलपमेंट को सप्रेस करता है और साथ में स्टेमन डेवलपमेंट को सप्रेस करता है. ये एस्पराजिस का वाई क्रोमोसोम जो होता है, इट सीम्स टू कैरी फंक्शनल एलील्स ऑफ ऑल द जीन्स दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स. सिंस वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम्स आर वायबल एंड फर्टाइल, मैंने जैसे आपसे कहा वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम्स फर्टाइल होती है एस्पराजिस के अंदर, तो इसलिए मतलब जो भी जीन्स प्रेजेंट थी मतलब एक्स क्रोमोसोम के अंदर जो वायबिलिटी के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट होती है वो वाई के अंदर भी प्रेजेंट होती है, इसलिए अपन इसको बोल सकते हैं कि होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम्स हैं, दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन एस्पराजिस एंड स्पिनच. ओके, एग्जाम्पल याद रखना. ठीक है, वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम्स अपन क्यों ऐसे ब्रीड करते हैं कि मतलब एस्पराजिस का मतलब जो लीफी पार्ट होता है वो बहुत उसका समथिंग कमर्शियल प्रोडक्शन के लिए ये सुपर मील्स बहुत ज्यादा मतलब एडवांटेजेस होते हैं एक्चुअली, बहुत ज्यादा क्या बोलते हैं प्रोडक्टिविटी देते हैं एक्चुअली वाई वाई जो मतलब इंडिविजुअल्स होते हैं, इसलिए ऐसे ब्रीड करते हैं इसको. आप ब्रीडिंग के अंदर पढ़ोगे ये एक्चुअली एस्पराजिस के अंदर ऐसा होता है. तो मतलब एंड सच प्लांट्स हैव नॉट बी ऑब्टेन इन एनी अदर प्लांट स्पीशीज. सो मैं इसलिए कह रही हूँ क्योंकि प्लांट्स के अंदर ही ऐसा होता है एक्चुअली, और इन स्पेशली द केस ऑफ एस्पराजिस एंड स्पिनच. इन केस ऑफ स्पिनच वेराइटीज आर ईदर डायोशियस एंड मोनोशियस. फिर इनकी क्रॉसेस के बारे में बोला है कि क्रॉसेस बिटवीन डायोशियस एंड मोनोशियस रिवील दैट द मेलनेस टू बी डोमिनेंट ओवर मोनोशियस कंडीशंस व्हिच इन टर्न इज डोमिनेंट ओवर द फीमेलनेस. इट इज सिमिलर टू द केस फाउंड इन स्पिटिंग क्यूक्यूम्बर. क्यूक्यूम्बर के अंदर भी ऐसा ही पाया गया है. फिर बस इतना ही है इसके अंदर, पढ़ने की जरूरत है. बस आपको पता चल गया कि मतलब एक्स वाई क्रोमोसोम आइडेंटिकल मॉर्फोलॉजी में भी होते हैं, साथ में जीन्स भी सिमिलर होती है, तो इसलिए मतलब ये दोनों वायबल होते हैं, वाई वाई क्रोमोसोम्स के जो इंडिविजुअल्स होते हैं, तो इसलिए अपन इसको होमोमॉर्फिक क्रोमोसोम्स कहते हैं. फिर हेटेरोगैमेटिक फीमेल एंड होमोगैमेटिक मेल. द ओनली क्रेक कट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ हेटेरोगैमेटिक फीमेल्स इन फाउंड इज फ्लैजेरिया एलिटेरिया. ये भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, फ्लैजेरिया ये पूछते हैं. द यूनिसेक्सुअल फ्लैजेरिया स्पीशीज आर ईदर टेट्राप्लॉइड, हेक्साप्लॉइड एंड ऑक्टोप्लॉइड. उनकी यूजुअल प्लॉइड यही होती है, टेट्राप्लॉइड, हेक्साप्लॉइड एंड ऑक्टोप्लॉइड. When females are crossed with diploid hermaphrodite species, the progeny are of following types: female and hermaphrodite, or female and male, depending on the cross. Clearly, females produce two types of gametes. इसके अंदर क्या किया इन्होंने? Females को hermaphrodite के साथ इन्होंने cross किया. तो इसको क्या मिला इनको? Females और hermaphrodite भी मिली, और females और males भी मिले कभी-कभार. तो इसका मतलब क्या है कि females produce करती हैं heterogametic sex. That's why मतलब तीनों के तीनों produce हो रहे हैं. ठीक है? और जब मेल्स को प्रोड्यू जब है ना क्रॉस किया तो इन्होंने क्या किया, मेल्स प्रोड्यू बट व्हेन मेल्स वर क्रॉस विद हर्मोफ्रोडाइट डिप्लॉयड स्पीशीज द प्रोजेनीज वर फुल ऑफ वन सेक्स ईदर मेल और हर्मोफ्रोडाइट डिपेंडिंग ऑन द क्रॉस. तो मतलब जब मेल्स को हर्मोफ्रोडाइट के साथ किया तो उन्होंने सिर्फ मेल और हर्मोफ्रोडाइट ही पाया. तो इसके वजह से उन्होंने क्या पता लगाया कि मतलब दे प्रोड्यूस ओनली वन टाइप ऑफ गैमेट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द सेक्स क्रोमोसोम एंड आर देयरफॉर द होमोगैमेटिक सेक्स. ठीक है, यहां तक समझ आ गया सबको?
मैम
हेलो
मैम, कुड यू प्लीज एक्सप्लेन इन इंग्लिश मैम.
ओके 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 ओके. यू वर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द फर्स्ट थिंग, एक्स एक्स फीमेल एंड एक्स वाई मेल?
यस मैम, बट इट्स मोर कन्वीनिएंटली इफ यू टेल इन इंग्लिश मैम.
ओके ओके, सॉरी सॉरी. ओके, आई थॉट एवरीवन नोज हिंदी, दैट्स व्हाई. सॉरी सॉरी मैम.
ओके ओके मैम. ओके
ओके, सो दिस इज द एक्स एक्स फीमेल एंड एक्स वाई मेल सिस्टम दैट इज फाउंड इन एस्पराजस एंड स्पिनच. Okay, those females are heterogametic, homogametic in nature, that is XX. So we will leave the females to that. While males are heterogametic in nature, that is they are possessing two types of sex chromosome, that is X and Y. You all know why they are classified in homomorphic sex chromosome is that because X and Y chromosome, they are identical in morphology. Okay, here they are having identical in morphology. We find these type of classification, that is homomorphic as well as heteromorphic in plants only, where they will include the XY male in homomorphic also and heteromorphic chromosome, sex chromosome. Under that, they will classify XY male as well. Okay, in animals, it will be the same only, that is heterogametic and homogametic. That heterogametic will be XY. Because in animals, there is clear-cut differentiation of morphology, that is X will be larger and Y will be smaller. Okay, here it is a different case because the X and Y will be identical in morphology and this aggregate randomly. And in addition to the major gene affecting the sex present on the X chromosome, the Y chromosome is thought to contain a gene that suppresses the carpal development. So Y chromosome will be having a gene that will suppress the carpal development and also another gene that promotes the stamen development. But the asparagus Y chromosome, it seems to carry functional alleles of all the genes that is present in the X chromosome, since YY plants are viable and fertile. Because as we see in animals actually, if YY chromosomes are present, or if we take the standard example of Drosophila, if YY chromosomes are present, so they will not survive, they are not viable. But in this case, YY chromosomes are viable in nature and they are fertile also. That means some of the genes that are present in X chromosome that are, you know, that are responsible for viability, because in sex chromosome, X is very important for viability in nature. Okay, so Y chromosome is only there to determine the maleness of that individual. Okay, male determining factor. Y chromosome is mainly for that. X is, along with, you know, sex determining factor, it is also having some vital genes present in the X chromosome. And that's why if this capital Y chromosome, if it is viable and fertile in nature, it means that Y, these chromosomes, genes present on X chromosomes will be present on Y chromosomes as well. Okay? Hello?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, and these chromosomes are present in Y chromosomes as well, and that's why they are viable as well as fertile. So That's why this XY male is categorized in homomorphic sex chromosome, because they are identical in nature also, and also the genes also are similar in nature. That's why YY chromosomes are fertile as well as viable. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there's not that much that else that is needed here actually. And other example, that is spitting cucumber. This is also one example here. And the main example is asparagus as well as spinach. You can take it down. Okay. Now, when we come to heterogametic female as well as homogametic male. So this is found in the case of Fragaria elitaria, that is wild strawberry. It is sometimes asked in the exam. So you have to write it down. Okay. So the unisexual Fragaria, it is the ploidy level are normally tetraploid, hexaploid and octaploid. And then when the females were crossed with diploid hermaphrodite species, what they found was they found female hermaphrodite and male also, okay, in the crosses. Okay, so when they cross female as well as hermaphrodite, they produced all the three sexes, that is female, male as well as hermaphrodite. So they concluded that female are producing two types of gametes, because they are producing all the three types of sexes. That's why they concluded that that female must be producing all the heterogametic chromosomes. While when they cross the male with the diploid hermaphrodite species, they only got male and hermaphrodite. So they concluded that the male plants produced only one type of gamete with respect to the sex chromosome, and therefore they were having the homogametic sex. Okay, understood till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the second that in the previous thing we learned, homomorphic sex chromosome, this is the heteromorphic sex chromosomes, and this mechanism, that is this mechanism is grouped into following three categories. We can see the following three types, that is XX female and XY male, that is a normal male, female male, and the second is XX female and XY1 Y2 male, and the third is X1 X1 X2 X2 female and X1 X2 Y1 Y2 male. Okay. So these three types of combinations were observed in heteromorphic sex chromosomes. So XX male and XY female, this system is most common in plants and is found in Cannabis, Psyllid, Rheumix, Hastatulus and Humulus lupulus. Okay. In these species, the plants are XX and the X will produce only one X chromosome. Male plants will be having XY chromosome and they will be containing both X and Y. Okay. And this is the normal, that is XX female and XY male. They will be having heteromorphic, that is a difference in the morphology of the sex chromosomes. So that is the XY male. Just note down the example, that is cannabisilin and cannabisilin, rubulus hastatulus and humulus lupulus. The second is XX female and XY1 Y2 male. This has been found in Rheumix acetosa and Rheumix hastatulus and humulus japonicus. So the plants will be having, female plants will be having 2X chromosomes, and hence all their X cells will be having 1X chromosome, normal. Okay, normal female. But plants will be having XY1, Y2 composition. So one half of the polygynes will have X chromosome and the other half, both will be having XY1, Y2 chromosomes. Okay, so fertilization, when it is fertilized with a female, what they will get, XX zygote, that is the normal X is going in one pollen grain, so it will be fertilizing with the 1X chromosome from the female, so it will produce XX zygote. And fertilization of the Y1 Y2 pollen with X chromosome will yield Y1 Y2 zygote, which will develop into male plant. That is seen in case of these Rheumix species and also humulus. Okay, so this is the picture, that is X female, XX female, when it is crossed with this type of male, that is XY1, Y2, they will produce 1X gamete, and then Y1, Y2 will go together in the one gamete, that is, that will fertilize with the X gamete and will produce X1, Y1, Y2 male, and this will produce female. That is the case for Rheumix acetosa, Hastatulus and Humulus japonicus. Okay, write down the examples, all of them. It cannot come in GRF as such, but in the long term, actually, it is very useful. Okay. And this is the case of this is the case that is found in Humulus lupulus. Some strains of Humulus lupulus, that is X1, X2, X2, and X1, X2, Y1, Y2. So females will be homogametic and all will be having X1, X2 chromosomes. Okay. The males will be heterogametic and it will produce two types of sperms, that is X1, X2 also, Y1, Y2. Okay. So this will produce the this constitution, that is X1, X2. When it fertilized with the X1, X2 of the females, it will yield an zygote that will be female in nature. And when the Y1, Y2 will cross with the X1, X2 chromosome, it will produce the male. Okay. Any problem in this till now? Any problem?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So third is the genic balance mechanism. This is the usual thing that you learn actually in the sex linkage. That is the most common thing that you learn in sex linkage. That is the Drosophila XYA autosomes. So the genic balance mechanism determination of sex, it was observed by C.B. Bridges in 1921. Write down, this is very important, who observed the genic balance mechanism while working with Drosophila for the inheritance of vermilion eye color. Okay, you have to write what is the experimental material, that is Drosophila, and what in what character was it found, that is vermilion eye color. Okay, this point is very important, write it down. So according to this mechanism, the sex of an individual in Drosophila melanogaster determined by the balance between the genes for the femaleness located in the X chromosome and those for the maleness located in autosomes. So a ratio of X chromosomes as well as the autosomal sets determine what the individual will be. Okay. So the sex index will be number of X chromosomes that are present in the individuals upon the number of autosomal sets. Autosomal sets are what? If it is 2N, what will the autosomal set?
XX plus 1.
Okay. Autosomal sets kitne honge? Matlab, how much will be the autosomal sets?
Half the times of autosomal.
No. Just tell me what is the number of set. If it is 2N diploid individual, what is the number of autosomal sets that it is getting?
1.
How it is 1?
Some 2n minus
2 times.
Ma'am, 2n equal to 40.
Some 2n minus 2 upon 2.
Sets matlab, sets in the case, how many times that, you know, that genome is repeated. So it is like 2n. So two autosomal sets are there. As simple as that. Don't complicate it like 2n minus 2 by 2 or something like that. If it is 2n, the number of autosomal sets will be 2 only. Okay. If it is 3N, number of autosomal sets, 3. Okay. Understood? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the sex index of individual. Now we have calculated the X chromosome by divided by autosomal sets actually, for example. So if the sex index comes 0.5, so it will produce normal male. Okay. If it is producing the sex index of 1, it will produce normal female. Sex index between 0.5 and 1, if it is coming, it will be neither a female or male, intermediate sex. It will be known as intersex and it will be sterile actually. These individuals will be sterile in nature. And if it is coming more than 1, so it will be having more pronounced female characters than normal females, and it will be known as super females or meta females. These are actually non-viable actually. These does not live up to maturity, and these are weak and sterile also because many X chromosomes are there, and that's why they will be sterile in nature and also non-viable also. Okay. As I said, X is very important for viability and all, and if it is more also, it is harmful, and if it is not there also, it is harmful in nature. So it should be in apt amount. So super male flies will be having the value of less than 0.5. okay, and they will be weak, sterile as well as non-viable. So it is very, very, very important. This is the most important of the sex linkage class actually, this thing. That is, you have to learn the sex index, what is the value, normal mates will be having 0.5, one will be having for normal females. If it is coming between 0.5 and 1, it is intersex and they will be steroid. More than one, super females or meta females, and they are generally non-viable, weak and sterile. And super male flies, they will be having less than 0.5, weak, sterile as well as non-viable. So that is the case for genic balance mechanism that is mainly found in Drosophila. So this is the sex mechanism that is found. Okay, that is the normal chromosomal sex. That is, ploidy level is 2N. Number of X chromosomes, they are having 3. Number of autosomal sets, what they are having? 2. So X by A, what it will be? 3 by 2, 1.5. 1.5 is what? Super female. So that way, all things are given. Okay? Anyone answer? Okay, is it okay till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now in plants also, it has been found actually, determination of sex by X by A balance in Rheumix acetosa actually, okay. So in other species of Rheumix, we had discussed that X1, X2, Y1, Y2 genic constitution. Rheumix acetosa, it is seen actually. This type of X by A autosomal balance is seen actually. Here, no need to learn actually these things in plants. Just remember the example actually, Rheumix acetosa. Just noted to remember the these things, but you have to learn what is in Drosophila. Drosophila, you have to learn. It is very mandatory. It will be, it can be asked actually. Now, fourth is male haploidy or haplodiploid mechanism or Erinotoccus parthenogenesis. Very important. Learn the synonym. That is Erinotoccus parthenogenesis. So it has been found in hymenopterous insect, that is ants, bees and wasps, and in honeybees, queen usually mates only one during its lifetime, and the sex ratio of offspring is under the control of the queen. So queen only decides whether it has to be fertile male, it has to be sterile female, or it has to be male. So a fertilized eggs actually develop into diploid female. And those eggs which queen chose not to be fertilized develop parthenogenetically into haploid but fertile male drones actually. Okay. So which are fertilized actually, they will be developing into female. And which are developing parthenogenetically without any fertilization, they will be developing into males, but which will be haploid in nature. They will be haploid males. Okay. And this phenomenon is known as erinotoxy. And it is a form of reproduction as well as means of sex determination. So meiosis, during the oogenesis, that is the formation of egg and all, it will be normal in case of females and it will produce all haploid eggs. But crossing over and reduction division fails to occur during the spermatogenesis in males due to their haploid nature. As they are haploid in nature, so there will be no spermatogenesis and all these things. There is no need for reduction of these sperms and all these things. And so there is no crossing over as well as reduction. Okay. And the Erinotoccus parthenogenesis determines the sex in the hymenopterans as well as sex and sex chromosomes have no identity here. Actually, here also there is no importance there, whether they are having X chromosomes or Y chromosomes. This is all divided. It is all depending upon the environment actually mainly. Okay. So further during the investigation, it has been found that quantity and quality of food also available to the diploid larvae determines whether the female will become a sterile worker or a fertile queen. Okay. So actually in the hive, when they are provided with food also, that quantity and quality of food also determines whether female will be sterile or fertile actually. And if it is fed on the royal jelly, it will develop into fertile female and it will be queen. And if the remaining larva, which give rise to workers, they will be sterile females. So only queen which is feeding on the royal jelly will be fertile and which will be able to multiply the colony, and rest will be the sterile females which are not given the royal jelly. That is in one of the research they have just found out that they will not be the royal jelly but the usual food. I don't know what is the food actually. So they will develop into sterile females. The environment here determines the sterility or fertility but does not alter the genetic determined sex. Okay, so it is altering the sterility, whether they should be sterile or fertile. But they are not deciding whether this should be male or this should be female or something like that. Okay. That is the case for male haploidy or haplodiploid mechanism or erinotoccus parthenogenesis. Any questions? Any questions?
Ma'am, please, can you explain this in short? Actually, I'm getting confused.
What you're confused with? What you're confused with, tell me.
I'm not getting completely. How does the haploid males develop on this?
What is the case is that fertilized eggs actually. So queen is producing eggs and the drones are actually fertilizing it. So if it is fertilized, then they will develop into diploid females actually. And if it is not fertilized, some eggs will be there which are not fertilized actually. And it is all decided by the queen only. Okay. This is a particular form of sex expression that is seen in case of this Hymenopterans actually. So actually some eggs will be there which will not be fertilized actually by the drones actually. And these eggs actually, they are haploid in nature. These eggs are haploid in nature. And so they will parthenogenetically develop into males actually. And they will be fertile in nature actually. Okay, understood till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so then actually these females are actually diploid in nature actually. So they will be having meiosis in normal during oogenesis and all these things. It will be normal in nature because they have to produce eggs, for their, for reproduction and all. They will be producing, they will be having oogenesis in oocytes. So it is actually normal actually, and they all produce haploid eggs actually. But in case of males actually, they are already haploid in nature. The individual itself is haploid in nature, and so crossing over and reduction division will not occur because spermatogenesis is not able to occur. What is spermatogenesis? That is formation of sperms. There is no need for reduction division because sperms already are haploid in nature in that individual itself, because that individual itself is haploid. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So that's why crossing over and reduction division does not occur. Okay. And so here it has been said that the quality and quantity of food also determines whether the sex that is clearly for the case of females actually. In the case of females, the quantity and quality of food determines whether the female should be sterile or fertile. So they will choose one individual which will be given royal jelly actually. Royal jelly is something, some substance or some the food actually. And the feeding of this royal jelly to a larva, it will develop into queen and it will be fertile in nature. Okay. But the rest of the colony, there will be many females actually, the rest of the colony will not be given royal jelly. So they will all develop into sterile female workers. Okay. So this royal jelly is given only to one diploid female, and that is the case that I don't know how they are selecting and all these, but this is given to only one diploid female, and that will later develop into queen. Kyunki in a hive, there is only one queen. So one larva, that is one diploid female, will be given this royal jelly, which will later develop into queen. Rest will be feeding on the normal substance, and they will develop into sterile female workers. And it is said that this product, that is the consumption of these substances, determines the sterility and fertility of that females. And that's why it is said that this environment here determines the sterility or fertility, but does not alter the genetically determined sex. They are already females, but whether to be sterile or fertile, it is determined by the royal jelly or the substance which is fed to the larvae. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Understood? Clearly understood?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So it is the case that is found in Hymenopteran species actually. This is the case for Hymenopteran species. Okay. And it can be asked in exams actually, Erinotoccus parthenogenesis. What is Erinotoccus parthenogenesis? In which species it is seen? That's the type of question that can be asked. And so you have to learn this. That is Erinotoccus parthenogenesis is this. Now, 5 is the single gene effect or monofactorial mechanism of sex determination. So there are some autosomal genes also that are controlling the sex of the individual besides the sex chromosomes. So we are going to see, okay, what are those cases actually? So in Neurospora, Asparagus, Drosophila, and Maize, sex determination is influenced by the differential action of a single autosomal gene. So one single autosomal gene can be there to determine the sex of the individual. Okay, till now we were seeing X and Y chromosome were able to determine the sex of the individual. Now there are some special cases where one single autosomal gene, that is not the sex chromosome, is able to determine the sex of the individual. Okay, so this is the first case that I've written, that is in Drosophila, that is the autosomal recessive transformer TRA gene. Okay, small TRA gene. So when it is present in homozygous recessive condition, it transforms the female zygote to develop into males, which are sterile. And it has no effect in males actually. If it is present in males actually, it has no effect. But if it is present along with female, along with XX chromosome, if recessive homozygous genes come of this TRA, it will convert the female zygote into males, and which will be sterile in nature. Okay, this has no effect when it comes with male. That is XY along with TRA, when it comes, it has no effect. And this heterozygous nature, it has also no effect. Okay, so only this recessive homozygous gene has effect on the individual. So when a heterozygous female, that is XX TRA has no effect when it is in heterozygous nature. When it was crossed with male, that is XY, and that is homozygous recessive gene, as it is said that there is no effect in male, so it will produce normal male only. So when it was produced, so it was seen that XX TRA, that is heterozygous, it is coming, TRA is heterozygous in nature, so female is fertile. XY male is there, but it is heterozygous in nature, so it is male fertile. So when it is coming in X along with XX along with recessive homozygous gene, so male sterile actually. It was observed that it was male sterile. XX, although XX gene is there, chromosome is there, but it was male sterile. Okay, so that's why it was transformed. And then XY, TRA, that is male fertile. So this gene was affecting the sterility of the individual in the Drosophila. So that is the case for single gene effect of sex determination. Now we will move on to plants actually. In plants also certain genes have been observed that are altering the sex or the expression of the sex of the individual. So monogenic control of sex has been reported in some plants like asparagus, maize, papaya, spinach, etc. You have to remember in plants, all the examples of plants. These all are not coming just for your, extra knowledge. I am just providing it to you. But you have to learn the plants example, okay. So asparagus, it is a dioecious plant. However, rarely female flowers bear rudimentary anthers as well as male flowers bear rudimentary pistils actually. So it is the case that is seen in asparagus. The female flowers will be bearing rudimentary anthers and male flowers will be bearing rudimentary pistils actually. So occasionally when the male flowers were with poorly developed pistils were selfed, they got a ratio of 3:1 of male as well as female also was observed. Okay, so they thought that this is they found out that this is due to a gene, that is P. So when P was present in heterozygous condition, that is these two plants that were present in heterozygous condition, these are male actually. Okay, so when they were crossed, so homozygous dominant produced male, heterozygous dominant produced male only, but homozygous recessive produced female. So this was due to a single gene, that is autosomal gene, that is P, that caused the formation of female in selfing of the male flowers. Understood? Understood? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this was due to one single autosomal gene which was deciding the sex of the individual. that has been observed in the case of asparagus. Asparagus only individuals that are having, you know, male flowers that is bearing rudimentary pistils. These are some cases actually that has been observed in asparagus. In maize also, see, monoecious plant bears both, this is very important actually. Maize, it is very important example. You have to, in further studies also, you will be learning this. The monoecious plants bear both female and male inflorescence on the same plant. As we all know that maize is a monoecious plant. So the recessive gene BA, that is BA, it is termed as barren cob. That is in homozygous condition, when it is present in homozygous condition, so cobs will become barren or non-functional. Okay. Now the another recessive gene is there, that is TS. When it is present in homozygous condition, it will produce TSTS. When it is present in TSTS condition, it convert the male flowers of the tassel into the female flowers. So BA, what it is causing the cobs to be barren or non-functional in nature. TS, what this it is doing, when it is present in homozygous recessive condition, it is causing the male flowers to convert into female flowers. Okay. And the gene BA converts the monoecious plant into male. Okay. Because it is converting cobs barren or non-functional. So we can also say that gene BA, it is converting the monoecious plant into male, because it is making the cobs non-functional. So we can say it is converting the plant into male. So when it is present in homozygous condition, it converts the monoecious plant into female, because what it is doing, it is converting the male flowers into female flowers. So from these two, we can infer this thing. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So when these are present in both dominant conditions, that is BA and TS, when it is present in dominant condition, they will be monoecious in nature. The plants will be monoecious in nature. But what when the BA, BA and TS is there? So when BA, BA is homozygous recessive condition, so it will produce normal male. When TS, TS is homozygous recessive condition, it produces female. And when these both are present together, they will produce rudimentary females. Okay. Understood? Till here you understood? It is a little bit confusing actually. So if there is any problem, you can just say. Hello?
Ma'am, can you repeat? I didn't get it.
Okay, actually in maize, monoecious plant bears both female as well as male. As you know, you will be knowing that it is monoecious in plant. Female and male inflorescence are present on the same plant. So these two genes are present actually, BA and TS genes are present in the individual. So when the BA gene is present in recessive condition, that is in homozygous condition, and what it does, it makes the cob barren or non-functional. So it will be, the females will be sterile in nature, okay, or non-functional in nature. So from this, what can we infer? If it is present in homozygous recessive condition, BA, BA. So it will convert the monoecious plant into male. Am I correct? Because it is converting the cobs barren or non-functional. So only the male are only functional in that plant. So it will convert the monoecious plant into male. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Another recessive gene is there, that is TS. That is in homozygous condition. Okay. When it is present in homozygous condition, it will convert the male flowers of the tassel into female flowers. Okay, it is converting the male flowers into female flowers. So when these are present in homozygous condition, what we can infer, that it will convert the monoecious plant into female. Because it is converting, male flower into female flower. So what it will do, when it is present in homozygous condition, it will convert the monoecious plant into female. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. When they are present in dominant condition, both of these genes are present in dominant conditions, they will produce monoecious plants. Okay, that is the case when they are present in both they are present in dominant condition. Okay.
Yes,
hello. Hello.
Yes,
understood.
Yes,
if you understood only, then only say yes, ma'am. Okay. Understood.
Yes, ma'am.
यस मैम.
ओके
मैम.
हाँ बोलो
मैम. हाउ रूडिमेंटरी फीमेल्स आर फॉर्मड इन लास्ट कंडीशन दैट इज बीए बीए टीएसटीएस.
एक्चुअली रूडिमेंटरी फीमेल्स दे आर एक्चुअली इफ इट इज प्रेजेंट इट विल कन्वर्ट द कॉर्प्स बैरन और नॉन फंक्शनल. ओके then TSTS are present. I think so there is some interaction between these genes. I will let you know in the next class. Okay. I think so there is some interaction between BA and TS that is converting these into rudimentary females.
Okay.
Okay. I'll let you know in the next class. Okay. So who was that who asked that question? Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
No, no, not you. The other girl.
It's me, ma'am.
Ah, okay. So when it is when that homozygous recessive condition of BA is there along with dominant TS condition, so BAB is expressed and so it will produce normal male because what it is doing, BA what is doing it is. Doing the corpse barren or non-functional in nature. So male are only left actually. So BA, BA will develop into normal male. Then capital BA, it is there, but small TS is also present in this. So what small TS is doing, converts the male flowers of tassel into female flowers. So it is converting into female. So the plant will be female in nature. And when both of them are present in recessive condition, they will produce the rudimentary females. The correct explanation of this I don't know. I will let you know in the next class. Okay, understood till now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here another example that is papaya. The sex is governed by three alleles, that is M1, M2, and small m of a single gene. The single genes having these multiple alleles and the expression of these multiple alleles or the constitution of these multiple alleles in an individual is deciding the sex of the individual. So homozygous recessive, that is small m will produce female flowers. Heterozygous m, capital M1 and small m, and also capital M2 and small m will produce male and hermaphrodite flowers respectively. So capital M1 along with small m will produce male, and M2 along with small m will produce hermaphrodite. And when these two alleles, that is M1 and M2, when they are present in dominant conditions, they will be inviable actually. Okay, when they are present in homozygous conditions or when they are present in heterozygous conditions, that is M1, M2 or M1, M1 and M2, M2, they will be non-viable in nature. So what they did, crosses between female, that is small m and male, that is M1 into M1 and small m. What they produced, males and females in the ratio 1:1. And when female and hermaphrodite was there, M2, M and small m, they produced 1:1 ratio. Similarly, okay, and then selfing of the hermaphrodite plants, that is M2, M plants, that is they produced hermaphrodite plants also, female plants also, that is selfing happening, so it will produce in 2:1 ratio, and about 1/4 of the zygotes were having M2, because here hermaphrodite plants, M2 is there, so they produced selfing, when they self, they produced M2 and they did not survive actually. So that is a simple case of papaya. You understood papaya?
Yes,
hello. Ma'am. Yeah, just 1:1 ratio, how it came, just to remember the case of test cross actually, when we are doing one heterozygous individual, it is not the test cross, just I am just for you to remember in head what is the why 1:1 ratio and all came, just M2M and what is that heterozygous recessive, so sorry, homozygous recessive individuals, so 1:1 ratio only will come actually, so that is the case, 1:1 ratio. Okay, just remember like that. Now till now, we were seeing that is these all things were controlled by one single gene actually. Okay, now it is multigenic sex determination. Many genes are coming together to determine the sex of the individual. And it has been found in this plant. That is, I have given one picture on the side actually, just to make it clear. Mercurialis annua. So no need to learn these things. Okay, just I have just shown you this because to clear you out, many genes are contributing to the sex of this individual. Okay, That is the multigenic sex determination in Mercurialis annua. Now, metabolically controlled sex determination, that is in pigeon and dove, it is seen actually increased rate of metabolism lead to the development of maleness, or decreased rate of metabolism, it will lead to femaleness. Okay, so that is the case of metabolic control mechanism. I have not seen it in plants actually, so I have not written. Now, how hormonally controlled mechanism, that is seen in chickens. Okay. Just remember the examples actually, no need to go through these things. The things that are important that I have briefed out, otherwise no need to go through these things. Okay. If you are studying these that I have, just compiled it in this sex linkage class, it's more than enough, because a sex linkage out of this thing, it will never come. That is, I'm sure of that. So, this is the another type of sex mechanism that is found in Coccinea indican melandrium album. So, in the by seeing this picture, you can say as X by A mechanism, it is coming like that, but it is not like that. Even as presence of single Y chromosome imparts maleness in these individuals. That is C. Here, XX chromosome is present, that is male. XY chromosome is present, that is male. Okay. But here, XYY chromosome is present, that is male. Okay. Here, see the example of XXY. If even one Y is coming, it will be male. So XXX, and then Y and Y is coming, so it will be male. So like that, it is C. Okay. It is seen in Coccinea indica. No matter how many. Okay. Hello.
We need to remember these ratios also, X by A.
X by A ratio only of Drosophila, only of Drosophila. I have, okay. Given the rumex acetosa also, but just for example, I had given that in plants also it is happening. For that also, I made you see that. Otherwise, just for Drosophila, it is very, very, very important. You can get one question. That is very important. That one slide was very important. That is genic balance mechanism. That is very important. Otherwise, for these all things, no need to remember. This is not at all necessary. Okay. Now, due to environmental factors, due to rise in temperature or decrease in the day length or something like that, maleness and femaleness can be expressed in individuals differently. So it has been in animals, it has been found in turtle, lizards, and Bonellia viridis. It is a type of worm actually. So it has been found in turtle, lizards. And sometimes they can ask actually in animals, in lizards and turtles and all, sex mechanism, how it is working and all. Just remember the examples. Okay, in plants such as Cucumis sativa and muskmelon, treatment with ethylene enhances the production of female flowers. In research purposes also, exogenous application of ethylene is done to induce the femaleness of individuals. Okay. So, exogenous application, that is the outside application of ethylene to the flowers plants of Cucumis sativa and muskmelon can give rise to female flowers. Okay. That is the case with environmental factors. Understood? Till now it is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, everyone? Yeah. Everyone? The girls?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what are all your names actually? I don't know the names of the girls. Hello?
Ma'am, my name is Payal Devnath.
What? Say it again.
Payal Devnath.
Payal. Okay.
Yes,
Payal.
Ma'am.
Okay. And the other girl?
Ma'am, Vandana.
Vandana. Okay. Now we will move on to the sex determination, that is in Y chromosomes, that has been seen in Y chromosome, how they are expressing or how they are interacting with each other. So we will see. Okay. So in plants, the Y chromosomes tends to be large in case of silent latifolia. Here the example is the case of example taken is the case of silent latifolia. It is the largest chromosome and carries about 10% of all the genomic DNA. I have taken the example of plants because we are dealing with plant science mainly. So I have taken like that, and humans are also there, but I just, we need to learn these only as, importantly, more importantly. So that's why I've taken this as an example. So in animal, Y chromosome tend to be very small. Rheumatoid acetosa Y chromosome are rich in highly, that is no need. Okay. The Y chromosome of S. latifolia has four functional segments which perform distinct functions. Okay. So they are divided. These two chromosomes are divided into certain regions according to their functions. Okay. So the first segment contain the, first we'll talk about the Y chromosomes. Okay. So Y chromosome are divided into four regions. So the first region is the female suppressor region and it's located on the one end of the Y chromosome. Okay. Okay, what is the case when a deletion, if deletion occurs in the female suppressor region?
Female will be produced only.
Female will be produced only, yeah. How?
मैम एक मिनट ये स्पीशीज टू स्पीशीज चेंज होता है क्या 1 2 3 4 रीजन
नहीं ऐसा तो चेंज नहीं होता क्यों
एक्चुअली मैंने मिलेंड्रम में पढ़ा था वहां पे फर्स्ट रीजन जो था वो मेल सप्रेशर था सेकंड वाला जो था मेल प्रोमोटर था थर्ड वाला फर्टिलिटी था और फोर्थ वाला पेयरिंग रीजन था
तो यही तो है इसके अंदर
मैम यहां पे फीमेल सप्रेशर है
फर्स्ट पे क्या था तुम्हारे वहां पे
मेल सप्रेशन
मेल सप्रेसर है वाई क्रोमोसोम के अंदर कैसे
यस मैम पता नहीं वहां पे मतलब लिखा हुआ
था सकता? ऐसा हो ही नहीं सकता मेल सप्रेसर वाई रीजन के अंदर कैसे हो सकता है
पता नहीं
आप एक बार और देखना जरा ठीक है ये नॉर्मल थिंग है एक्चुअली
फोंडन थिंग में देखा था ये मिलेंड्रम एल्बम में लिखा हुआ था जिसमें कि वाई क्रोमोसोम पे सारे मेल के ही रिलेटेड मेल सप्रेशन मेल प्रोमोटर मेल फर्टिलिटी और फोर्थ रीजन
मेल का कुछ और होगा वो इट इज नॉट मेल सप्रेसर तो कभी हो ही नहीं सकता वाई क्रोमोसोम के अंदर मेल सप्रेसर कैसे आ गया आप ये सोचो ना एक बार कहां से पढ़ा था आपने वो
फुंडन सिंह में था
अच्छा अच्छा
मिलेंड्रियम एल्बम
ठीक है मैं देखूंगी बट ये एक्चुअली द थिंग इज ये स्टैंडर्ड थिंग है एक्चुअली बाकी किसी ने पढ़ा रेस्ट एनीवन हैव लर्नड दिस टाइप यू नो दैट कंपोजिशन ऑफ दैट एक्स एंड वाई क्रोमोसोम रेस्ट एनीवन हैव लर्नड
नो मैम
ओके 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 सो एक्चुअली योर नेम इज अंकित नो
यस मैम
अंकित को एक बार फिर से देखना मुझे नहीं लगता उसे मेल सप्रेसर होगा कुछ और होगा वो दैट इज फॉर श्योर बिकॉज वाई क्रोमोसोम के अंदर कभी मेल सप्रेसर रीजन आ नहीं सकता एक्स के अंदर आ सकता है पूछ सकती हूँ या फिर आप उसके अंदर एक्स क्रोमोसोम का बात कर रहे होंगे जो बोल रहे हो आप
नहीं मैम मैं फोटो भेजता हूँ ग्रुप में एक मिनट
ठीक है सो टिल देन वील कंटिन्यू विद दिस ओके अ डिलीशन इन द फर्स्ट सेगमेंट वॉट इट विल कॉज
मैम इंटरसेक्स
हाँ इंटरसेक्स नहीं बोल सकते हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स या ओके इंटरसेक्स अपन ऐसे बोल नहीं सकते बिकॉज दे विल बी लाइक यू नो फर्टाइल स्टेराइल होते हैं एक्चुअली इंटरसेक्स आप ऐसे उसे बोल नहीं सकते हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स बोल दोनों फंक्शनल होंगे मतलब ऐसे ठीक है तो द डिलीशन इन दिस रीजन विल प्रोड्यूस हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स ओके हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स इन द plants okay in the xy plants that is the male plants agar uske andar if there is deletion in the female suppressor region it will produce xy plants okay let me see the photo actually Ankit, I think so there is some problem in this. I don't think so it is true. Ankit?
Yes, ma'am.
मुझे नहीं लगता उसके अंदर वो है actually. मतलब सही है वो चीज
ठीक है
मुझे तो लग रहा है फीमेल सप्रेसर ही होना चाहिए बिकॉज इसके अंदर और कोई रीजन ऐसा नहीं है. देयर इज नो अनदर रीजन इन द वाई क्रोमोसोम दैट इज यू नो प्रमोटिंग दैट इज हैविंग द यू नो दैट इज सप्रेसिंग द female. So there should be some region that should promote that should suppress the female expressing region, otherwise hermaphrodite plants can occur. So I think so Kundan Singh, I'll refer and tell. Okay, so this is we'll move forward. Okay, the deletion in this segment produce hermaphrodite flowers. The second region that is has gene that promote the maleness, that is it initiate the development of the stamens, that is the male promoter region. Okay, it initiates the development of stamens, and the deletion for this region give rise to asexual flowers on the XY plants. So asexual, agar ye chala gaya, agar iske andar chala gaya, aur agar iske andar ye hua nahi, to iske andar asexual flowers already the plants are male male originate. That is only male flowers are present in the male reproductive organs are present in the XY plants. If it is not there, it will not produce. It will not be helping in the development of the stamens, and so asexual plants will be produced where no male stamens will be there. Okay, so the third segment, it contains the gene that governs the male fertility as well as the anther maturation. A deletion for this region produces the male sterile plants with abortive anthers. So anthers will be produced, but the deletion of this region can produce sterile anthers or also abortive anthers. Okay, in the second region, if there is a deletion in the second region, no male organs will be produced. But when the third region, that is the male fertility region, anthers will be produced, but they will be sterile in nature and they will be abortive in nature. That is the case of third segment. Now the fourth segment located at the other end of the Y chromosome. Hello.
Ma'am, if the second region lost, ho gaya, to female produce hogi.
नहीं 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 फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन तो ऑलरेडी है ना उसके अंदर.
अच्छा, तो मतलब बिना मेल बिना फीमेल का होगा वो.
हाँ, एसेक्सुअल प्लांट एंड एक्सवाई क्रोमोसोम. एसेक्सुअल प्लांट, एक्चुअली एक्सवाई प्लांट की बात कर रहे हैं ना अपन. एक्सवाई प्लांट की बात कर रहे हैं तो उसके अंदर क्या होगा? मेल होगा, ओनली मेल होगा. अगर फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन इसके अंदर एक्चुअली हियर एक्स क्रोमोसोम इज प्रेजेंट इन दिस इंडिविजुअल. सो this first region, that is female suppressor region, is acting to suppress the female expression, that is the X chromosome expression ko wo suppress karne kaam karta actually. Agar ye male promoter region chala gaya to iske andar anthers produce honge. Anthers hi hote hain basically iske andar. Samajh aaya?
Yes ma'am.
Samajh aaya to bolo, warna main fir se samjha dungi.
फीमेल प्रोड्यूस भी नहीं होगी ना यहाँ, तो वैसे भी सप्रेस कर ही देगा.
देखो, फर्स्ट वाला रीजन क्या करता है? सप्रेस करता है ये एक्स का जो प्रोडक्शन होता है इसको सप्रेस करने का काम करता है फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन. ठीक है, ये जो प्लांट है ये प्रोड्यूस करेगा सिर्फ एंथर्स को ही प्रोड्यूस करेगा. ठीक है, अगर ये फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन प्रोड्यूस नहीं, अगर ये खत्म हो गया तो इसका मतलब ये फीमेल्स भी प्रोड्यूस मतलब एक्सप्रेस करेंगे तो क्या प्रोड्यूस होगा? हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स प्रोड्यूस होगा. इसके अंदर एंथर्स भी होंगे साथ में मतलब फीमेल पार्ट्स भी होंगे. बट ये मेल प्रमोटर रीजन जो होता है ये क्या करता है कि मतलब प्रमोट मेलनेस और दिस इनिशिएट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द स्टेमेंस. सो डिलीशन फॉर दिस विल गिव राइज टू एसेक्सुअल फ्लावर्स. तो इसके अंदर ऑलरेडी फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन तो है तो मतलब फीमेल्स का तो छोड़ो, वो तो होगा ही नहीं. बट फीमेल मतलब मेल्स का जो डेवलपमेंट स्टेमेंस का डेवलपमेंट है वो ये कर रहा था सेकेंड रीजन.
अब वो भी नहीं करेगा,
वो नहीं करेगा तो एसेक्सुअल फ्लावर्स विल प्रोड्यूस.
वही मैम, तो कुछ नहीं बचा मतलब वही उसको भी दबा दिया और ये भी चला गया.
या सो नथिंग विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. ओके, अंडरस्टूड?
यस मैम.
ओके, द थर्ड सेगमेंट कंटेन्स जीन गवर्निंग द मेल फर्टिलिटी एंड एंथर मैच्योरेशन. सो हियर द एंथर्स विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. इन द सेकंड केस व्हाट वाज दैट? डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द स्टेमेंस वाज affecting and so it was not able to produce stamens. But the third region, that is the male fertility region, so anthers are there but the fertility is decided by this third region. So a deletion in this segment will produce male sterile plants, or the abortive stamens will be produced. Okay, so when we'll see the flower, stamens will be there, but it will be abortive in nature. Okay, that is the case for male fertility region. The fourth segment, located at the other end of the Y chromosome, is homologous to a segment of the X chromosome. Pairing between X and Y chromosome in this region ensures the separation at anaphase 1 of meiosis. So in the previous class, as I was saying, actually, this fourth region, that is the pairing region, actually. So there are some genes present in the X and Y chromosome that are similar in nature. And why they are similar in nature? Just to pair, make them pair during the anaphase, so that they are not got lost during the division of meiosis. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, everyone understood?
Girl? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, can now, these pairing regions be called as pseudo-autosomal regions?
Yeah, that is known as pseudo-autosomal region. Okay, pseudo-autosomal region bolte inko. Inka zyada koi function. They don't have that much function. They don't have that much function. Just for pairing sake, they are there. Okay, that's the case for pseudo-autosomal region. That is, I was going to ask at the end of the this class actually, what are these regions actually? You said it well during this class only, so you can all write it down. That are pseudo-autosomal regions. That is the fourth and these two regions are known as pseudo-autosomal region. They have nothing. More important to offer. Only thing is that they will be, holding the X and Y chromosome together during the division. That's all they do. That's the case for fourth region on X and Y chromosome. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. A large part of the X chromosome is non-homologous to the Y chromosome. This region has gene governing the development of female reproductive organs. As I said earlier, for this fifth region, the suppression of this region only, female suppressor region is there. Okay? Ankit, understood now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. That's all actually. The function of genes is how it's suppressed by those located in the segment 1 of the Y chromosome. Single Y chromosome is able to produce fertile male flowers even in the presence of 4X chromosomes. Okay, that's all. And in males, in actually mammals, the situation is changed. SRY gene, that is SRY gene, it regulates the sex determination. At least two genes are necessary for sex determination in plants actually. So two genes are necessary for the sex determination in plants, but in case of mammals, only SRY gene is mainly responsible for the sex determination in plants. So these two genes will be, one gene suppresses the carpal development, other gene is essential for the stamen development. That's all. These two genes, that is second and third, these two genes are required for the sex determination in plants. Now we will move on to sex linkage. Give me just 5 minutes. Hello?
This one.
Just 5 minutes, okay? I'll come. Hello? Okay. Next is the sex linkage. Till now, we were discussing about sex determination. Now, sex linkage. There are certain experiments that were done in Drosophila by some scientists that determine that there are some certain genes that are linked to the X chromosome of the individual. Okay, so this is known as sex linkage, and there are three experiments mainly that were that proved that certain genes are linked to the X chromosome. Okay, so first one is the inheritance of Y-type gene in Drosophila. It is very, very important. You have to learn in sex linkage. What? Hello?
Ma'am, last slide में आपने एक चीज बोला था कि reason number 2 और reason number 3 को sex determination में use करते हैं.
Wait. हाँ, बोलो.
हाँ, there you said that reason 2 and 3 are basically used for sex determination. Two is okay, but why we are going for three? Like, it is only for this fertility or sterility factor. One and two could be used in better way, right?
Better way, हाँ, choose कर सकते actually, but determine कौन करता actually? कि मतलब male promoter region क्या करता है? कि मतलब male promoter क्या करता है? कि मतलब promote maleness actually. ओके, तो इसके अंदर अगर फीमेल सप्रेसर रीजन अगर चला भी गया तो कम से कम वो मतलब सब वो कर रहा है ना एक्चुअली. दोनों एक्चुअली हर्मोफ्रोडाइट फ्लावर्स प्रोड्यूस हो रहे हैं, मेल एंड फीमेल दोनों प्रोड्यूस हो रहे हैं एक्चुअली. मेल में कोई वो नहीं हो रहा, समझ आया? हेलो,
हाँ, मतलब लेकिन थर्ड वाले का तो कुछ यूज नहीं रहा ना, वो तो स्टेरिलिटी फर्टिलिटी के लिए है सर.
हाँ, तो दैट इज आल्सो एन इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर इन डिटरमाइनिंग द सेक्स एक्चुअली. एक तो So next we will move on to sex linkage, inheritance of Y-type gene in Drosophila. So isko sabse pehle done by Morgan in Drosophila. Sorry for beech mein Hindi it's coming actually. So sorry for that. Okay. So sex linkage next is the topic. So it is the most important experiment that was done in sex linkage. That is inheritance of Y-type gene in Drosophila. It was done by Morgan in Drosophila. It is very important. Who did the experiment? That is Morgan. So what he did was he crossed red eyed female with white eyed male. Okay, so in the progeny what they observed was red eyed mainly red eyed they observed, but what they observed when they did the F2 individuals what they got was 3 red is to white, 1 white. So it is a normal ratio that has to be got. But what did what was the peculiar feature of this experiment was that all the male individuals were having white eyed and none of the female individuals were having white eyed character. So F1 all were having red eyes, but in the F2 only the male were having white eyed character, but the females were all red eyed, and males were also having red eyed, but only the white eyed character was expressed only in the males. So what he did was he done a reciprocal cross. Okay, in the reciprocal cross what he got was 1 red is to 1 white in the F1 generation, but in the F1 generation also all the females were red eyed, but the white eyed individuals were all male actually. So when he did the F2 individuals, he observed that they were having 1 red is to 1 white ratio, and in that females were having white and also males were having white. So they were actually having this doubt actually why they are getting this, that is 1:1 ratio in the individuals, that is in the F1 also and in the F2 individuals also. Okay, so they thought that there must be these genes must be had to do something with the sex chromosomes of the individual. So when they attributed this genes to the sex chromosomes of the individual, they got the correct constitution that they had got in the experiment. So So what they did, that is, if the parents, that female, that is having the red progeny. So if in the F1, all were red in nature. So in the previous F1 itself, they found out that red is the dominant character and white is the recessive character. And so they crossed a red-dyed female with a white-dyed male. So what the gametes will be? Female will produce only one type of gamete, that is the red type of gamete, and male will produce white type of white colored, that is the genes that are having white colored eye, and that is having and other is the Y chromosome. When they crossed, they got red individuals, and males also were having red individuals. And when the F2 was obtained, when they put the checkerboard and then they analyzed, they were able to get the progenies as females were having red in red, and males were also having red. That is the and this is the chromosome that they got from the females, and this is the chromosome that they got from the females. Yeah. Male also were having the red individuals. They crossed the red individuals actually, and they got the red individuals. And the F2, all the females were red in color. That is that they were having red eyed color. That is red, and males were also having red in color. That is, they obtained males half red and half white. So they inferred that this was present in the X chromosome of the individual. And when they crossed the reciprocal cross, they called, so white-eyed female produced only white-eyed white-colored gamete. The gamete that was having the white-colored eye, and the red individual that was having the red male, it produced only one type it produced one gamete that was having red, that is the homozygous dominant one. And when they crossed, they got red and white individuals. And when these were crossed, that is the F2 individuals, when they were crossed actually, they got this ratio. So when they got this ratio, they were able to infer that these chromosomes were present in the this gene was present in the X chromosome. That's how they got the result actually, when they assumed that these genes were present in the X chromosome of the individual. Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the fly room, that is where this these all experiments were conducted. This is the famous fly room that these men, Morgan and all, Sturtevant and all these scientists conducted their experiments. So second is a non-disjunction of chromosomes. And this was done by, anybody knows this was done by whom?
Bridges.
Yeah, Bridges in 1960 while studying the inheritance of vermilion eye color in Drosophila. So this is the important thing that has to be remembered in the disjunction of the X chromosome. So what is this vermilion eye color? It is sex-linked recessive gene. So it is a recessive gene actually. It is denoted by the letter small w. And normally they should get, that is, red-eyed females as well as vermilion males, they should get. But what they got was, some had vermilion females and red-eyed male also. Okay, so it cannot get like that, because it is a sex, although it is a sex-linked recessive gene, so red-eyed should be produced actually, but red-eyed females should be produced, but they got vermilion females as well as red-eyed males. So what they inferred was that there should have been some disjunction in the chromosomes of X chromosomes. That is, abnormal females must have been had some non-disjunction of the chromosomes, which had led to the development of vermilion females. So here it is the chromosomal constitution, that is vermilion females, that is small v, small v, when crossed with red-eyed individuals, that is male. So due to the non-disjunction, this gamete will receive what? Small v, and this will not receive anything. Okay, so no X. So only this one gamete is receiving the two X gametes. And Y, that is normally one is receiving V, and that is the capital red-eyed colored gamete, and the other one is receiving the Y chromosome, that is a normal thing. So when the progeny was analyzed, they got that is super female that was having 3X chromosomes. And so it is super female. As I said, that super female dies actually. It is not, more than X chromosomes also. It is very, lethal for individuals actually, mainly for mammals and, living organisms such as that. Plants can, plants are able to moderate these type of effects, but animals are not able to. So super females, these will die. So when it is crossed with X chromosome, this when it is crossed with V, that super female it is produced, it dies. When when it is crossed with Y, it will produce XXY, and it will be a female, that is vermilionite female. Okay, so the other gamete that is containing no X chromosome, when it is crossed with V, that is producing the red-eyed male. And the other gamete that is no X is there. So as I said, if there is no X, it will die. So it is the case of, so then they infer that there must have been the case of non-disjunction in the X chromosome. That's why vermilion females were produced. That is the case of non-disjunction. In this also, you just remember the name. And in this also, and in which character it was done. And in this also, just remember the name as well as in which character, that is vermilion eye color Drosophila, it was done. Now the attached X chromosome in Drosophila. So in 1922, Morgan obtained a female Drosophila with yellow body color, which when mated with a gray body male, produced all females with yellow body color and all males with gray body color. But yellow body color is recessive to normal body gray color. So yellow is recessive to normal body gray color and is determined by the gene Y on the X chromosome. So this is the case. So they inferred that non-disjunction of X chromosome in all the oocytes of these abnormal females, this had led to the development of attached X chromosomes. Okay, some aberrations could have happened during the non-disjunction or something like that, that had given rise to this attached X chromosome, and that's how it gave rise to this progeny. So one gamete will receive this whole X chromosome, other gamete, no X chromosome. So males, one will be receiving this X chromosome that is having the dominant gray color, and this will be no X chromosome, only Y chromosome. When the progenies, super females will be produced, that is having three chromosomes, that is having the, it will ordinarily die actually. Super females all will die, and this produce, that is XXY will produce yellow bodied female, because only this chromosome came to this individual, so it will produce only yellow bodied female XXY, and this will produce males actually, that is XO, that is it will produce gray bodied individuals, and the other thing, that is having no X chromosome, it will die. So this is the case for attached X chromosomes in Drosophila. Understood,
ma'am? Ek secondary non-disjunction bhi hota hai, as like primary non-disjunction. So ma'am,
secondary non-disjunction.
Yes, ma'am.
हाँ.
तो मैम ये जो प्राइमरी नॉन डिसजंक्शन है वो सुपर फीमेल के चलते बेसिकली अराइज होता है.
कैसे, मैं समझ नहीं आ क्या बोल रही हूँ.
जैसे नॉन डिसजंक्शन का मतलब ही होता है ना कि सेपरेट नहीं हो पाता.
हाँ, हो ही नहीं पाता.
तो वो सुपर फीमेल के केस में ही ये दिखता है ना, प्राइमरी नॉन डिसजंक्शन.
सुपर फीमेल एज इन नहीं होगा, उस ऑसाइट के अंदर कुछ हुआ होगा जिसके वजह से वो दोनों गैमेट साथ में गए होंगे.
तो मैम सेकेंडरी में फिर क्या होता है, सेकेंडरी नॉन डिसजंक्शन में?
सेकेंडरी और सब मुझे लगा क्रोमोसोमल एब्रेशंस में पढ़ेंगे, तो अपन वहां पे देखेंगे. मेरे को अभी इसके बारे में कुछ आईडिया नहीं सेकेंडरी के बारे में.
ओके,
ठीक है. ये अभी मतलब क्रोमोसोम्स के अंदर जो गैमेट्स था उसके अंदर कुछ प्रॉब्लम हुई होगी जिसके अंदर से ये नॉन दो क्रोमोसोम्स आए होंगे, तो उसके वजह से हुआ है नॉन डिसजंक्शन. these secondary disjunctions and all these we will study in the chromosomal aberration class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now there is one other terminology, that is sex-linked inheritance. The characters for which the genes are located on the X chromosomes or analogous Z chromosomes. Birds or reptiles ke andar, in birds and reptiles, Z chromosomes are there. It is known as sex-linked characters. So such genes are called sex-linked genes, and linkage of such genes are known as sex linkage. And the inheritance of these characters, sex-linked inheritance. It was first discovered by T.H. Morgan in Drosophila. So this is important. T.H. Morgan discovered this sex-linked inheritance in Drosophila. That was the white-eyed gene in Drosophila. Okay. So in human beings, this has been observed, that is in color blindness and hemophilia. Okay. These are the well-known hereditary characters showing a peculiar relationship to sex. Okay. And the genes are present in the when the genes are present in non-homologous regions of the Y chromosome, this actually passed from male to male. And the examples, actually non-homologous regions means these are not homologous to the X chromosome. So these chromosomes, these regions will be having certain genes which are only needed for male development. For example, these are known as the holandric genes actually. For example, hypotrichosis, that is, the excessive development of hairs on the pin of ear. You must have seen in males excessive, yeah, that is the case of hypertrichosis. So this is transmitted directly from father to son. Okay, and this color blindness as well as hemophilia, these show crisscross inheritance. What are crisscross inheritance?
Alternatively appearance of trait from...
Alternatively, matlab?
Matlab, suppose grandfather ko tha, phir female ke through uske granddaughter ko ya kisi ko hoga.
हाँ, granddaughter के बाद भी नहीं, मतलब father to daughter या son to mother, ऐसे उसे बोलते हैं crisscross inheritance.
Yes.
आप जैसा बोल रहे हो वो भी सही है, generation to generation, but crisscross inheritance अपन बोल सकते हैं father to daughter या son to mother, ऐसे उसे बोलते हैं crisscross inheritance. और उसका opposite है ये Hollandric genes जो होता है वो मतलब father to son जाता है या mother to daughter जाता है, जो चीजें जो certain genes होती हैं, certain genes are there which are passed on from father to son. These are Hollandric genes and these are little opposite to color blindness and hemophilia genes, because these show crisscross inheritance, that is mother to son or father to daughter, these types of things. Okay.
X linked gene और sex linkage same है?
Hello, what?
X linked gene और sex linkage same है?
मेरे को समझ नहीं आया, फिर से बोलना.
Sex linked inheritance और X या X related जो genes होते हैं वो same है?
Yeah, X linked inheritance can also be known as sex linked inheritance.
Okay.
Now the second is sex influence traits. So sex influence genes are the autosomal genes that are present in both males and females whose phenotypic expression is different in different sexes in such a way that they act as dominant in one sex and recessive in the other sex. Okay, so these the genes for these traits will be present in both male as well as the female also, but the expression will be more dominant in case of one particular sex. Actually, it can be expressed in both the sex, but more dominantly in one sex it is produced actually. So that is the case for sex influence traits. Okay. So example, that is pattern baldness in human beings and horns in sheep. So I have given the pattern baldness in case of humans actually. So capital B, it can be expressed as male also. Sometimes it is expressed in female also. If it is heterozygous in condition, baldness is produced in male actually, but it is not produced in female. It homozygous recessive condition, it is produced in non-bald in both the genotypes. Okay, so more, it is more predominant in male as compared to females. Females it is producing, but it in certain cases, and it is under the regulation of certain sex hormones that it is produced. Okay, understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So another one is the sex limited characters or secondary sexual characters. So these are limited to autosomal genes whose phenotypic expression is limited to one sex only. Okay. So only one sex is expressing these particular characters. So these, their phenotypic expression is under the sex hormones, under the control of the sex hormones. And the sex limited genes are mainly responsible for secondary sex characters in cattle, human beings and fowl. So for the example will be milk production in cattle, beard development in human beings, plumage in male fowls. So it will be produced in only the phenotypic expression of these characters will be expressed in only one sex only, actually, not in the case of other sex. That is the case for sex limited characters. Sex influence characters, sometimes it can produce in the in both the individuals also, but in sex limited characters mainly it is for one sex only. That is the case for sex limited characters. So this is the difference between sex linked as well as sex limited characters. They are located on the sex or X chromosomes. They are located on the sex chromosomes or autosomes. So that is the main difference between this sex linked as well as sex limited characters. They are present on the autosomes, and sex linked is present on the X chromosome only. That's why Ankit, it is said sex linked X linked bhi bol sakte isko, theek hai? They can express in both. They are expressed in both the sexes. They can express in only one sex only. Okay. Include characters are not related to sex also, and include primary as well as secondary sex characters actually. Because in not related to sex, as in the case of hemophilia and all these things, these are not related to sex actually. They are the result of sex linked characters, but they are not affecting the sex of the individual. But here, sex limited characters, they are affecting the primary as well as secondary sex characters, that are the sex limited characters. Okay, so example, white eye in drosophila, hemophilia, color blindness in human beings, etc. Here, milk production in cattle, beard development in human beings, plumage in male fowls, etc. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So there is another term, that is gynandromorphs, that has been seen in drosophila. So they are actually a type of, you know, mosaic where... Hello? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Somebody had some problem? No?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So these are seen in drosophila actually. There will be a mosaic actually. The progeny itself will be a mosaic. Mosaic in the sense that half of the part will be male and half of the part will be female. This is the case of gynandromorphs or gynanders. Okay? That is the case for drosophila. That is the one terminology. So with this, we conclude the sex linkage class. So actually, if you have time, you can see some CTEC questions. Actually, you want to see some CTEC questions?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I have just some questions. Actually, we can do it every Sunday. Actually, if I'm taking class actually, and in between 1 week also, we can take some. You know, just questions actually. So if you have any doubt in that, I'll just clarify it in the next class, because I am not even, you know, that much knowing about CTEC, but I will make you know, clear about that, you know, any questions you are having. So you can just start answering the question actually. Okay, tassel is the staminate inflorescence of
mage.
Okay, where are the girls actually?
Yes.
Okay. Girls, I want to hear from the girls actually. Okay. Okay. The mode of pollination in maize is
cross.
Girls. Okay. Cross pollination. 3. The male inflorescence of maize is boys.
Tassel.
Okay. Pollination of maize is by.
Tassel.
By. Pollination of maize is by.
Wind.
Insect.
Okay. No. Wind. याद रखना विंड है. ओके, ये लिख के रखो ये चीजें. दीज थिंग्स आर एक्चुअली, यू नो, यू विल नॉट, यू नो, व्हेन यू आर स्टडिंग दीज थिंग्स, नो सीटेक क्वेश्चंस एंड ऑल, यू विल नॉट बी, यू नो, यू विल नॉट बी, व्हाट टू से, नो, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू नोट दीज थिंग्स, बिकॉज यू विल से दैट इट इज वेरी सिंपल सच एज दैट, बट इन एग्जाम्स इट इज वेरी कंफ्यूजिंग इन नेचर. सो पॉलिनेशन इन मेज इज बाय विंड. ओके. 5. क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन इज रैडिश इज फेवर्ड बाय
इंसेक्ट्स.
Yeah, insects. Okay, next questions. Next question, ladkiyan bolenge. Inflorescence in carrot flower is called
ma'am umbel.
Ladkiyan.
Umpa. compound umbel. Second option D.
B. Okay. Compound umbel. In fluorescence in carrot flower is compound umbel. Okay. Pollination in cauliflower is done by
honeybee.
Yeah, honeybee. Eight, that is harvestable maturity stage for bhinde is
hairline crack formation.
Yeah, okay. You just remember all the harvestable maturity stage for every crop. Okay, that is very important actually. Many crops they have a distinct harvestable maturity stage for every crop actually. So you have to remember main things. Okay. Example of a dioecious fruit crop.
Papaya.
Okay. अब लड़कियां बोलेंगी, अब लड़कियां बोलेंगी. 10. Pollination is CF affected by.
Water.
Hello. बीच में किसी ने बोला था ना अभी?
मैम बी ऑप्शन.
10 का क्या है? 10 का क्या है?
बी ऑप्शन.
Animals. Animals बोला. Your answer is D, animals.
No, ma'am. B option, water.
B, water. Okay. Just don't answer as B or D. Actually, it's very confusing. Just answer the word actually. Okay, what? It's not water actually. It's insects. Pollination is T affected by insects. The only cone-bearing angiosperm is.
Pinus elliotti.
No. Casuarina equisetti folly.
C option, pinus.
No, pinus. Casuarina, angiosperm, casuarina. Casuarina equisetti folly. Only hai to isliye yaad rakhna. Only cone bearing angiosperm hai ye. Theek hai? That is casuarina equisetti folly. So, 12. Girls will answer. The monoecious plant normally having unisexual flowers.
Males.
Yeah. Okay. Now, boys, example for self-pollination.
Tomato, chili. Tomato bhi hota hai, chili bhi hota hai.
Chili ke andar actually, I think so, thoda
amount of cross-pollination. Hota hai, ma'am.
Yeah. So, tomato that is tomato. Hota. Yeah. Just remember the examples. Actually, it is very important. Often cross, it is always, you know, we will confuse with self-pollination. So, okay, 13 is A. That is self-pollination tomato. Okay, this everyone can answer. The crop with the longest style.
Maize.
Yeah, maize is the crop with the longest style. Okay, self-incompatible crop.
Onion.
Nahi. Girls, anyone?
Then that's
cabbage. Cabbage is self-incompatible crop.
Then sporophytic type of self-incompatibility is not in this age.
Ah, wahi hai, cabbage. Heterostyly favors, what it favors heterostyly?
Cross pollination.
Yeah. Okay. Can you see the questions actually? Can you see the this bar?
Yes, ma'am.
You are seeing this bar, that green bar?
Yes, ma'am. In laptop it is.
No. Can you see this green bar that is there?
रेड कलर का पॉइंटर है बस
वही दिख रहा तुम्हें?
यस मैम.
ओके ठीक है मुझे लगा एक्चुअली वो जो बार होता है ना जिसके अंदर होता है वो सब, तो इसलिए मेरे को लगा वो भी दिख रहा था. एक्चुअली आई कैन नॉट सी, दैट्स व्हाई. ओके, मैच्योरिटी ऑफ स्टेमेंस एंड पिस्टल्स एंड डिफरेंट टाइम इज कॉल्ड
डाइकोगैमी.
या ओके. फ्लावर कलर क्या होता है? क्वालिटेटिव होता है, क्वांटिटेटिव होता है, क्या होता है?
ट्रूली क्वालिटेटिव.
या ट्रूली क्वालिटेटिव.
मेंडल का एक्सपेरिमेंट हुआ था इसी पे तो.
या तो मतलब वो कैरेक्टर. देन हॉलो स्टाइल इज कॉमन इन
That's groundnut.
Hollow type.
Cotton, ma'am, होगा मालवेसी family.
नहीं, 19A है. Maize के अंदर होता है hollow style. ठीक है. ठीक है. Flower of flowering of inflorescence from bottom to top. Girls will answer. क्या क्या क्या
एक्रोपेटल
एक्रोपेटल ओके. व्हाट इज रेसिपेटल
टॉप
स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम टॉप एंड देन गोज टू बॉटम.
ओके. पेंट्रिपेटल
सेम टाइम पे मतलब होते जाते हैं मैच्योर होते हैं फिर बाद में ऊपर बनते जाते हैं.
सेम टाइम में मतलब
मैम बाहर से अंदर की तरफ मैच्योरिटी आती जाती है इनफ्लोरेसेंस में मैच्योरिटी
मतलब ऊपर से मतलब साइड से जो पेरिफेरी होता है वहां से शुरू होके मतलब सेंटर को जाते हैं लोग ऐसा होता है
सनफ्लावर.
यस
या या ओके. नाउ द किंग ऑफ कॉस ग्रेन वो क्या पेरिपेटल एक्चुअली आई हैड सीन इट एक्चुअली आई रेफर्ड एक्चुअली इट इज एक्चुअली जस्ट फॉर सम नेम एक्चुअली दे हैव पुट इट एक्चुअली देयर इज नो सच थिंग एज पेरिपेटल इन फ्लावर सक्सेशन. ओके. So these three are the main thing that is acropetal, facipetal and centripetal. Okay, there is no thing such as peripetal. Now, king of coarse grain is?
Jowar.
Jowar. B, okay. Fifth, prevention of self-pollination by flower structure is girls. Hello? हेलो गर्ल्स ये आंसर देंगे.
मैं क्वेश्चन नंबर 21 है 22
किंग ऑफ कॉस्ट ग्रेन इज स्ट्रॉवर. ओके 22 क्या है आंसर क्या है.
मैम फोर्थ ऑप्शन
डाइको क्या भी वो तो अपने पहले ही बोल दिया ना वो तो है नहीं. फ्लावर स्ट्रक्चर के बेसिस पे एक्चुअली वो कैसे डिफरेंशिएट देखो ऊपर देखो 17 के अंदर क्या है मैच्योरिटी ऑफ स्टेमेंस एंड पिस्टल्स एंड डिफरेंट टाइम इज कॉल्ड दैट इज नोन एज डाइकोगेमी. ओके. मतलब दोनों डिफरेंट टाइप्स में मतलब मैच्योर हो रहे हैं उसको अपन बोलेंगे डाइकोगेमी. अब इसके अंदर क्या बोल रहा है कि फ्लावर स्ट्रक्चर के बेसिस पे दे आर प्रिवेंटिंग सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन बेसिस ऑन दिस फ्लावर स्ट्रक्चर. So what is the answer?
C option लग रहा है but पता नहीं है.
Alpha alpha ma'am tripping करते हैं.
Harpogamy is the answer. Difference in flower structure that will prevent the self pollination. Okay, that is the case for harpogamy. Okay, remember this. This is very this is important also. Harpogamy, dichogamy. And you know learn the difference between these things. Dichogamy, harpogamy. Okay. Rain favors the pollination in 23. क्या है?
Cardamom.
No.
Yes.
Yeah, it's very important actually. It is most important case. One of the important cases actually. Because ये मैंने बहुत questions में भी देखा है. In competitive exams also sometimes they ask actually. It is
pepper. Important
question. Yes. Pepper. Just remember it like that. Pepper कहाँ से आता है? Land of spices. Kerala से आता है मतलब. पेरला में क्या है रेन आता है रेन उसको हेल्प करता है पॉलिनेशन के लिए. सो पेपर रेन फेवर्स द पॉलिनेशन इन पेपर. ओके
24 कंप्लीट फ्लावर
फ्लोरल प्लांट्स या ओके कंप्लीट फ्लावर 25 अब ये गर्ल्स बोलेंगे इफ द फ्लावर इज हैविंग ओनली मेल एंड फीमेल ऑर्गन्स देन इट इज नोन एज क्या 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 हेलो
मैम इम्परफेक्ट फ्लावर
इम्परफेक्ट नहीं
परफेक्ट होगा मैम
या परफेक्ट फ्लावर. ओके
इन द केस इफ अ फ्लावर इज हैविंग मेल एंड ऑर्गन मेल एंड फीमेल ऑर्गन बोथ इट इज नोन एज परफेक्ट फ्लावर. complete flower ka bolenge when it is having all the four flower structure, that is stamens, pistils, sepals as well as petals. If it is present, it is known as complete flower. Incomplete ka bolenge if sepals are not present, or if petals are not present, or if you know stamens are not present and any all the three is present, is known as incomplete flower. A perfect flower in the case when both the sex organs are present in the plant. So these are different actually. Just learn it that way, okay? So 26. If the flower is gynoecium only, that flower is named as
pistillate
flower. Okay. Okay. If the flower is androecium,
staminate.
Okay. That's all for today. Actually, it was very long class. That's why I thought some questions. The next class we'll do something around 50 questions. Okay.
मैम नेक्स्ट स्लाइड करना प्लीज नेक्स्ट
कौन सा ये वाला
हाँ यस
मैम क्वेश्चन
हेलो
मैम इसके आगे वाला
इसमें आगे वाला क्वेश्चन
कौन सा
बस
मैम एक क्वेश्चन पूछना है
हाँ बोलो
मैम बीडी सिंह में लिखा हुआ है इन पार्शियल सेक्स लिंकेज मैम दैट पार्शियल सेक्स लिंकेज आर जीन लोकेटेड इन एक्स क्रोमोसोम शोस ऑटोसोमल इनहेरिटेंस पैटर्न बट सच अ जीन विल शो लिंकेज विद दोज जीन्स दैट शो टिपिकल सेक्स लिंक्ड इनहेरिटेंस दिस हैज बीन क्लियरली शोन फॉर बार्ब्ड ब्रिसल्स ऑफ ड्रोसोफिला ये बीडी सिंह में मैम सेक्स लिंक चैप्टर की लास्ट फोर लाइन्स है
हाँ हाँ बोलो हाँ
यही है
तो इसमें क्या है मुझे समझ नहीं आया इसमें क्या
क्या इसका मीनिंग है
रुक मैं एक पढ़ के देखते हैं जरा मेरे पास है That should gene will show linkage with those genes that show typical sex linked inheritance. This has been clearly shown for past results in Drosophila. बोल रहे थे मतलब सेक्स एक्स क्रोमोसोम्स जो है वो ऑटोसोमल इनहेरिटेंस पैटर्न दिखाएगा है ना बट इट्स सच अ जीन विल शो लिंकेज With those genes that show typical sex linked inheritance, that is clearly been demonstrated for Barb results in Drosophila. हर्ष मैं तुम्हें नेक्स्ट क्लास में बताऊं ये मैंने पढ़ा नहीं एक्चुअली पार्शियल सेक्स लिंकेज
ओके नो प्रॉब्लम
ठीक है मैं तुम्हें नेक्स्ट क्लास में बताती हूँ ये पूरा देखना पड़ेगा मुझे देखना ठीक है चलो फिर मैं आज की क्लास फिर खत्म कर रही हूँ ठीक है
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.